Good morning and welcome to the Breakfast News on Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor and here are the latest headlines. Way cleared for the GST bill. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley says consensus has been reached on key aspects of the Constitution Amendment Bill. Congress isolated on key demand. Mahanadi battle in Parliament. BJD MPs raised matter in both houses of Parliament to protest construction of dams and barrages on the river by Chhattisgarh. Party also rejects Congress's proposal of an all-party meet on the issue. Iram Sharmila to end a 16-year fast against AFSPA. Iron Lady to contest the upcoming Manipur Assembly elections as an independent candidate. After failing dope test, Narsingh Yadav replaced with Praveen Rana for Rio Olympics. Wrestling Federation of India says if found innocent, Narsingh will be reinstated. And it is official, Hillary Clinton gets a Democratic nomination for the White House, becomes first woman in US history to be nominated for president by any major party. Well, the top story this morning, states have cleared the way for the central government to present the Goods and Services Tax Bill, which seeks to implement a mega reform for the approval of the Rajya Sabha. At a meeting on Tuesday with the Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, the states found consensus on all outstanding issues, leaving the Congress isolated. Now, states agreed that the GST cap demanded by Congress would not be required in the bill. States have cleared the way for central government to present the goods and services tax for the approval of the Rajya Sabha. At a meeting of the Empowered Committee of State Finance Ministers convened by Finance Minister Arun Jaitley on Tuesday, the centre and states agreed to include in the Constitutional Amendment Bill the mechanism of compensating states for any loss of revenue in first 5 years of GST implementation.
There was always a standing issue on the question of dual control. Dual control between state and centre. It was a unanimous decision of the finance minister, conveyed to the union finance minister, that 1.5 crores and below will be only state, will be the only entity that will look after the small businesses of the states. In other words, single control.
There has been growing consensus in the Empowered Committee. One, everybody is agreed upon. Everyone is agreed upon to have certainty in the constitutional amendment for the compensation system. Whatever amendments the states put forward have been accepted.
The GST taxation should be specifically brought in legislation. And the rate should be told so that the taxpayer also will be capped.
An agreement was also reached on the principle that tax rate will be lower than the current levels, even as the broad consensus emerged that the rate should not be part of the regulation. The finance ministers also agreed that a cap on the rate of GST will not be mentioned in the main bill, isolating the Congress, which has cited this as a key demand. GST bill intends to convert 29 states into a single market through a new indirect tax regime. The government is keen to get the law passed during the current monsoon session of Parliament. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV. Now, employing a child below 14 years of age in any occupation except where the child helps his family will now invite imprisonment of up to 2 years. The Parliament on Tuesday approved the Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Amendment Bill. The bill, which was passed by Lok Sabha on Tuesday, defines children between 14 to 18 years as adolescents and lays down that they should not be employed in any hazardous occupations and processes. The bill was earlier passed by Rajya Sabha on 19th of July.
Which can be implemented at grassroots level.
The Lok Sabha on Tuesday passed the Child Labour Prohibition and Amendment Bill 2016. This makes employment of children below 14 years as cognizable offence for employers and provides for penalty for parents. According to the provisions of the bill, children below 14 years of age are permitted to work in family enterprises after school and on holiday. Labour Minister Bandaru Dattatreya called the bill historic, which seeks to totally prohibit children below 14 years to indulge in all occupations.
चौदह साल के नीचे काम करने वाले कोई बच्चा किसी फैक्ट्री में, शॉप में, मेल में, माल में, कोई एस्टेब्लिशमेंट में कहाँ भी काम नहीं करना पड़ेगा, ये टोटली बैन करना, ऐसा आप लोगों का सबके मन के विचार है, यही विचार इस बिल में है। किसान
से जुड़े हैं किसान। The bill was passed after a 5-hour long discussion in which 37 MPs participated. Several MPs voiced strong reservation against many of its clauses. The MPs raised objections to the definition of family, which includes not only parents and siblings, but also the siblings of either parent.
उसमें helping family in non-hazardous work, in audio-visual industry, sports activity, add कर रहे हैं। हमारा जो original act था, कोई add करने का सवाल ही नहीं था। हालांकि उसको delete करते जाना ये था। तो आज फिर आप ला रहे हैं। किनकी बात सुन के ला रहे हैं?
Sir, this bill has not clarified one thing completely, which is 70% of children, sir, that we talk about work as an aide in the contractual labour with their parents, which is actually bonded labour, which is not skilling at all, which is done against their will, which is akin to slavery of a sort, sir. So this has to be clarified in this bill, because this, when we look at, sir, the census of 2001, we look at the paan and beedi production, which together is 21% of child labour. So most of these instances are not parents just teaching their children their craft and passing it down the line. A lot of instances are children being oppressed against their will.
The bill also brings down the list of hazardous occupations from the earlier 83 to just 3. The bill defines children between 14 to 18 years as adolescents and lays down that they should not be employed in any hazardous occupations and processes. The penalty for employing a child has been increased to imprisonment between 6 months and 2 years or a fine of 20,000 to 50,000 rupees. The bill was passed by Rajya Sabha on 19th of July. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV. And BJD on Tuesday rejected a proposal for convening an all-party meeting on the Mahanadi water issue as its MPs raised the matter in the Lok Sabha. The centre has now asked the two concerned states, Chhattisgarh and Odisha, to discuss the issue at a 29th of July meeting. It has also offered forming a tribunal to settle the dispute if no solution could be found amicably. With Odisha and Chhattisgarh sparring over barrages being constructed on the Mahanadi River, Centre promised to explore a solution acceptable to both states and urged them to set up a joint control board to deal with such issues in the future. Minister of State for Water Resources Sanjeev Balyan said that the centre was only an intermediary as the issue was majorly a state subject.
यहाँ से उड़ीसा सरकार को, छत्तीसगढ़ सरकार को कहा गया कि आप आके बैठ के बातचीत कीजिए, क्योंकि केंद्र सरकार एज ए मीडिएटर का रोल प्ले करता है। पहली मीटिंग 27 जून को थी, अब अगली मीटिंग 29 जुलाई को फिक्स कर दी गई है, जिसमें दोनों सरकारों को सूचना दे दी गई है। एक साल का समय केंद्र सरकार के पास है, दोनों बातचीत करके अगर रास्ता निकाला जाए, अगर रास्ता नहीं निकलता तो ट्रिब्यूनल का गठन किया जाएगा।
बालियान वॉज रिप्लाइंग टू अ कॉलिंग अटेंशन मोशन बाय बीजेडी एमपी भरतुहारी मोहताब on undertaking of barrage projects over river Mahanadi by Chhattisgarh, thereby severely impacting flow of water into Hirakund Dam in Odisha. Raising the issue, Mahatab had demanded that construction of projects by Chhattisgarh should be stopped on the Mahanadi River, as it will severely impact irrigation and drinking water availability in Odisha.
Chhattisgarh government is saying these are all minor projects, and for minor projects we need not inform anyone. But when we club these six projects together, amount to as big as a large project.
While BJP MP from Chhattisgarh suggested constitution of a national river basin organization to settle such disputes, Water Resources Minister Uma Bharti promised to come up with an amicable solution at an upcoming meeting on the issue. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV. Meanwhile, in the Rajya Sabha, the centre assured the Odisha government that its interest will be protection in the construction of barrages across Mahanadi River by Chhattisgarh. Now, Water Resources Minister Uma Bharti said this in Rajya Sabha in her reply to a calling attention motion on the issue moved by the BJD members. Earlier moving the motion, BJD leader Dilip Kumar Tirki said that the Chhattisgarh government has unilaterally making barrages across the river just upstream of the Hirakund Dam. Now, that is, he said, jeopardizing lives and livelihood of millions of farmers in Odisha. He said that Chhattisgarh had decided to construct 10 dams on Mahanadi Basin, of which 2 to 3 dams are already constructed. Other members also sought clarifications on the minister's reply. Later, dissatisfied with the government's response, the BJD member staged a walkout of the house.
दोनों सरकारों से बात की जाएगी और इसका कोई ना कोई हल निकाला जाएगा. सबसे पहले उड़ीसा सरकार को इंटरस्टेट रिवर वाटर डिस्प्यूट एक्ट के सेक्शन 3 के अंतर्गत केंद्र सरकार को रिप्रेजेंटेशन देनी होगी. उसके बाद केंद्र सरकार एज ए मीडिएटर का रोल प्ले करेगी और अगर मीडिएशन न हो पाया तो ट्रिब्यूनल का गठन किया जाएगा. यही एकमात्र इसमें हल है.
कभी भी ओडिशा गवर्नमेंट के साथ कंसर्न नहीं किए, कभी इन्फॉर्म किया नहीं गया, कभी बताया नहीं गया. महोदय, इससे हमारे ओडिशा के लगभग 50% लोगों को डायरेक्ट इफेक्ट करेगा, 65% इनडायरेक्टली इफेक्ट करेगा.
ट्राइज टू एवॉल्व ए कॉम्प्रेंसिव ओवरऑल पॉलिसी सो दैट ए कंसेंसस इज बिल्ट अप. No quarrel on river water because it leads to conflicts among states.
And in more news from Rajya Sabha, well, the opposition led by the JMM and the Congress accused the ruling BJP of intimidation and threats in the recent biennial posts to Rajya Sabha. Now, opposition members also sought a House committee to investigate the alleged misuse of administrative machinery in the Jharkhand during polls. The government, however, refuted the allegations of misuse of office and assured a fair probe.
Raising the issue during Zero Hour, Sanjeev Kumar of the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha alleged that on the eve of polling, two opposition MLAs were harassed in some old cases, while one JMM MLA was arrested in a petty case to prevent him from casting his vote. Maintaining that a copy of the CD proving coercion by a police officer would be made available to the Union Home Minister, the JMM member demanded strict action against the police officer.
मैं संसद को बताना चाहता हूं महोदय, जब विधायकों को धन बल एवं अन्य संवैधानिक ताकतों से अपने समर्थन में वोट डालने पर तैयार नहीं काज किया जा सका, तब दो विधायकों को पुराना केसों के नाम पर इतना परेशान किया गया कि वे वोट नहीं डाल सके.
Leader of opposition Ghulam Nabi Azad corroborated Kumar's stance and alleged that the ruling party had resorted to decadent measures to win Rajya Sabha seats. He also demanded formation of a house committee to probe the incident. The JDU and the CPIM later also joined ranks with the Congress.
मोटे संबरडी बन गया है गवर्नमेंट का. ये इस गवर्नमेंट का के सीनियर आईएएस ऑफिसर्स को इलेक्शन जीतने के लिए एमएलएज को धमकाना, उनको डराना और अपने कैंडिडेट को जिताना, ये तो बिल्कुल अनडेमोक्रेटिक है, अनएक्सेप्टेड.
मैं सरकार से विनती करूंगा कि इन चुनावों में कोई किसी तरह की भी धांधली जो होती है वो इस देश के लिए बहुत गंभीर और सदन के लिए बहुत गंभीर होगा. इसलिए मैं आपसे कहता हूं कि ये जो इसको बहुत
गवर्नमेंट टू दैट लेट दैट सीडी बी गिवन दैट शुड बी इन्वेस्टिगेटेड प्रॉपरली एंड द गिल्ट शुड बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड पनिश्ड.
Rubbishing accusations of irregularities, Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi upheld the credibility of the Election Commission.
चुनाव आयोग की विश्वसनीयता और चालू चुनाव आयोग के कामकाज पर हम सबको विश्वास है. हम सबको किसी भी तरह से चुनाव आयोग के कामकाज और विश्वसनीयता पर शक करने का कोई कारण नहीं है.
The government further asserted that action will be initiated as per procedure. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
In breakfast news, time for a very short break. We'll be back with more news. Stay tuned.
Life after death was a cardinal belief in the Harappan civilization. Reflecting this is the skeleton of a middle-aged woman with gold bangles. Excavated from Rakhigarhi in Haryana, it's an example of the burial practices in those times. Much like the Egyptian mummies, vessels, eatables, ornaments were kept near the dead body in the hope that they would be of use to the person in the next world.
Hemkund Sahib, sacred shrine of the Sikhs, widely acclaimed for being the highest in the world, located in the Himalayas at an altitude of 15,200 feet. The Gurudwara is designed with an image of an upside-down lotus flower.
Welcome back after the break. Now, there is a huge setback for India in the Antrix Devas case. Now, an international tribunal in The Hague has ruled against the Indian government over the cancellation of a contract between telecommunications firm Devas Multimedia and Antrix Corporation Limited. Now, the decision is likely to cost India billions of dollars in damages. The case pertains to 2005 when ISRO's commercial arm Antrix Corporation entered an agreement with Devas to lease out satellite spectrum that the Bangalore-based company could use to provide high-quality telephony and internet services. According to the deal, Antrix would launch two ISRO satellites and leave nearly 70 megahertz of S-band satellite spectrum to Devas for 12 years. In return, Devas committed to paying an upfront fee of over $30 million. But in 2011, ISRO annulled the agreement after an audit report showed irregularities in the agreement. The Permanent Court of Arbitration has now ruled that the government's actions is annulling the ISRO-Devas contract had breached treaty commitments to accord fair treatment in Devas's foreign investors. News from Manipur. Well, Iron Lady Irom Sharmila Chanu, who has been on a fast since November 2000 as a mark of protest against the Armed Forces Special Powers Act or the AFSPA there, will now end her hunger strike. Now, 16 years after starting her hunger strike demanding the repeal of the act, the Iron Lady from Manipur announced that she will end her fast on 9th of August and also contest the Manipur Assembly elections as an independent candidate. The 44-year-old human rights activist said that she would join politics as she no longer believes that her fast would lead to the repeal of what she calls is a draconian act. Sharmila, who has refused to eat or drink anything since November 2000, is being force-fed through a nasal tube in Imphal's Jawaharlal Nehru Hospital. She is in a special ward which serves as her prison. Now, the assembly elections are due early next year in Manipur. Her decision was welcomed by the BJP and the Congress. On to some other news. In the foundation stone for a national memorial of APJ Abdul Kalam will be laid in Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu today to mark the first death anniversary of the former president. The Defence Ministry has planned a host of events, including the foundation stone laying for a national memorial for Dr. Kalam, unveiling his life-size statue and a 3D model of the memorial. The Minister for Urban Development, M. Venkaiah Naidu, and Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar will unveil the statue and the memorial model, an exhibition named Mission of Life, depicting the life of Dr. Kalam and his achievements towards nation building, will also be inaugurated. Meanwhile, to mark the first death anniversary of Dr. Kalam, IIM Shillong, where the former president breathed his last during a lecture, will organise the lecture series on making a world a better planet. And a weather update. Well, the central government on Tuesday assured all help to the flood-ravaged Assam in dealing with the crisis. Now, nearly 13 lakh people are reeling under the fury of floods in 18 districts of the state. Flood situation has also aggravated further in Arunachal Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal.
The centre will send a team to assess the current flood situation in Assam. The Brahmaputra River is flowing above danger mark in the state. About 12.5 lakh people are affected as flood waters submerged thousands of houses and agriculture fields. Over 20,000 people have taken shelter in 18 relief camps set up by the government. Two World Heritage sites, the Kaziranga and Manas National Parks, are also submerged.
140 gaon abhi affect hua aaj tak. Mane 140 gaon pe hum relief material de diya aur ye Brahmaputra nadi bhi mane डेंजर लेवल के ऊपर मैंने भर रहे हैं मैंने फ्लो हो रहे हैं वो जो ब्रह्मपुत्र का पानी कम हो जाएगा तो फ्लड सिचुएशन तो कम हो जाएगा
At least 4 people died in the last 24 hours as the flood situation worsened in 3 districts of West Bengal. More than 58,000 people are affected in 150 villages of Jalpaiguri and Cooch Behar districts.
Most affected states are Assam, West Bengal, Bihar, Arunachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. And all these states have been reeling under flood situation simply because in certain states there has been some rain, there has been heavy to very heavy rains, and also because of the release of water from Nepal.
The situation in flood-ravaged Namsai and East Siang districts of Arunachal Pradesh is also grim. There are reports of fresh areas being inundated by several rivers that are flowing above danger mark. The weatherman has warned of heavy rains in Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Meghalaya, Bihar, Haryana and Delhi. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
On to the big international story, and U.S. Democrats made history as Hillary Clinton was on Tuesday named the presidential nominee. The historic vote at the Democratic National Convention ended with Bernie Sanders calling for unanimous nomination in a bid to tamp down discord within the party.
Democrats on Tuesday officially nominated Hillary Clinton as their nominee in the presidential contest. The official vote, a significant moment in American political history, with Clinton becoming the first woman to be nominated for president by any major party. Clinton passed the 2,382 delegates needed to claim the nomination after South Dakota announced its delegate vote count.
She's a leader. So on behalf of all the women who have broken down barriers for others, and with an eye toward the barriers ahead, I proudly praise Hillary Clinton's name and nomination to be the next president.
Clinton's nomination comes at a time when there is a lingering discord within the party. Despite Clinton finishing the Democratic primary with 2,807 delegates, compared with rival Bernie Sanders' 1,894, a faction of the Sanders supporters threatened a floor fight or contested vote on the floor over the nomination. They were further emboldened by leaked emails showing personal bias towards Clinton among officials at the Democratic National Committee. In a bid for party unity, in a symbolic gesture, Sanders took the microphone to move to suspend the procedural rules and declare Clinton as the nominee.
And I move that Hillary Clinton be selected as the nominee of the Democratic Party for President of the United States.
Sanders has moved in the spirit of unity to suspend the rules. To suspend the rules and nominate Hillary Clinton by acclamation as the presidential candidate of the Democratic Party. Is there a second? All in favor of the motion say aye.
With the show of unity, Democrats hope that this will prove the rallying cry the party needs as it prepares for an election battle with Republican nominee Donald Trump. Trump was formally nominated at his party's convention in Cleveland last week. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, Somalia has risen at least 13th death toll after 2 car bombs went off in the vicinity of Mogadishu International Airport early on Tuesday. The Al-Qaeda-linked terrorist group Al-Shabaab has claimed responsibility for the attacks, in which 5 people were also injured. The attack happened when an explosive-laden car tried to speed through the barrier at the UN Mine Action Services office in Mogadishu. Al-Shabaab is waging an insurgency war against Somalia's weak UN-backed government. Let's get you some more international stories in World Wrap. One of the men suspected of killing a priest at a church in northern France was being monitored by the police. Prosecutors say that the accused, Adel Kermish, was twice arrested last year trying to reach Syria. Kermish and fellow attackers stormed the church in Rosen during morning mass. They slit the throat of an elderly priest before being killed by the police. The suspended Brazilian president Dilma Rousseff says that she will not attend the opening ceremony of the Rio Games because she does not want to take a secondary position at the stadium. She would have been placed in the stadium below interim president Michel Temer and not by his side. Her predecessor Luiz Silva has also refused the invitation. Now, both have said that they are being politically prosecuted by Temer's party and the allies. Rousseff faces possible removal from office if she loses an impeachment trial shortly afterwards the game, and Lula is also facing corruption allegations. The United States hopes to announce in early August details of planned military cooperation and intelligence sharing with Russia on Syria. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry said that Washington and Moscow, who support opposing sides in Syria's five-year-old conflict, had made progress in recent days towards working more closely together. A UN envoy also said that he would also aim to resume peace talks next month. On to the big sports story, and the Wrestling Federation of India has replaced Narsingh Yadav with Praveen Rana in the 74-kilogram category of wrestling for the Rio Olympics. A freestyle wrestler, Rana had earlier won a gold medal in the 74 kilograms category at the Dave Schultz Memorial Wrestling Tournament in US in 2014. Narsingh was handed provisional suspension and his Olympics accreditation was withheld after he failed a dope test on Sunday.
मैं दुख व्यक्त करता हूं नरसिंह भाई के लिए, उनके साथ जो हुआ गलत हुआ है, लेकिन जैसा मुझे अभी आदेश मिला फेडरेशन से कि अभी मुझे खेलना है, तो अब जिम्मेवारी है तो अच्छे से ट्रेनिंग करनी है। अभी दो हफ्ते बचे हैं क्योंकि हमारे पास, तो जैसा फेडरेशन ने आदेश दिया है वैसा मैं कर रहा हूँ और अच्छी ट्रेनिंग करेंगे।
Well, that's all in this edition of news, but news and updates continue on Rajya Sabha TV. Thanks for watching.